All right, I got one of my little bricks of sugar that I'm going to slip into one of my beehives. Let's go do it. Okay, I've got my little brick of sugar here, and I think it's going to work great when I have the chance to open up the hives, but today might not be the best day to do that because lots of wind, lots of snow, a lot of cold air blowing into the hives. Not a good day to open up a hive. So. Let's come back later, some other day. Soon, I hope. Okay, here we go. Moment of truth. Here's our little brick of sugar. I've got the top off of this hive and a little bit of hard insulation over the inner cover in this particular hive. This yellow bit here is a rim. The rim will make room for the sugar. And this hive already has some sugar in it, but I'm going to top it up with this little brick of sugar, and I can see that the bees are over here already eating the old sugar. And there, you can see it right there. So I'm just going to put the sugar brick right on top of that. I don't have my hands on the camera right now, just sort of hanging off my neck, so I don't know how well this is going to turn out, but here we go. Now see, that's right over the bees. I don't want to squish these bees, so I'll come back in a little while, maybe in a week or a month, and see if they've eaten that sugar, at least that sugar brick. And there's a little defensive bee there, dying in the snow now. Okay, the bees in this hive have a moisture quilt on top. And hold on. Ooh, I can tell they're a little bit defensive. Let me just take a look here. Yeah, they're a little bit, a little bit active here. This is difficult to film and do at the same time. Anyway, here we go. Okay. I wasn't able to get that on film, but you can see in here, the brick is way back there, and these bees are defensive, so I'm just going to leave them alone. Alright, well, that may not have been the best demonstration on how to slip bricks, sugar bricks in the hive, but basically you've got a rim to make room for the sugar. This is a rim here, and that's it. Do it on a day when it's not too windy, not too cold. I've used smoke once in a while to get through the bees if they're clinging to the in this case a moisture quilt, but the inner cover. So I'll come back in a couple weeks just to see if they're eating the sugar, and that's about it. That's all I can think of right now.